still leaking. The problem was, it was going down this side, but not coming out this side. And it took 3 days of hammering and wrenching and spraying WD-40 and everything else to get that cleanout plug out. But I got it out, and sure enough, when I ran water on this side, nothing was coming out this side. Rotting this out was not an option. As you saw previously, the outlet goes all the way down to the bottom of the grease trap. So basically, the water has to rise, oh, probably to about there before the water finally starts flowing out. But it wasn't doing it, and I knew what the problem was. There was a clog somewhere in here. I could get my hand around there, and that was clear. So it was somewhere in this shaft, because that's basically what it is. Like I say, you could not get a snake up in there. So the other solution, which finally worked, was to get a rubber mallet and just start tapping on the outside over here and on this part right here. And as I started tapping and running water, the water started flowing out of here because I had the clean out off. Yes, it ran into the saucepan I had very strategically placed underneath it. So we got that back together. I didn't have time to set up the camera to show you guys how I did it. I mean, if you're a homeowner, you can pretty much guess. Then, as my dad used to do, I poured a bottle of lye in here. And I'm going to get another bottle and pour it. And he used to do about 3 bottles of lye with each clean out that he did. I put some in the drain to clean out this pipe, and hopefully that should do it. What a job. Well, this is why you have to do it every 6 months like clockwork, because when it clogs, it clogs. And this house is almost 60 years old. So, at least it's not a turn of the last century house. I can't imagine what I'd have to deal with there. Now this is what it's supposed to do. The water level's supposed to rise up. See it rising there. You see that kind of dark area? And then there's a light area above it. The dark area is where the water is supposed to stop. Now I've got it on full blast. And you see it rising. When it gets to the top of that dark area, it's going to stop. And the water on this side will just keep going out. So it won't overflow. Yeah, now the water level will just stay right there. Then, when I shut the water off, the level will start to go down. Going down, going down. And then when it gets to a certain point, actually about the level of this pipe, it'll stop. And like I say, my dad, once he would clean the trap out, he would put 3 bottles of lye crystals down there. And, you know, then close it up and let it sit. Same thing I did. So I shouldn't have to do this job again for another 6 months. Oh, one other thing. Another place that it was leaking was right here. There was a pinhole there. And that's one reason that, remember the lid was kind of corroded? That's because water was leaking onto it. So anyway, I'm gonna respray that since we got a nice 50 degree day. And now you see where the water's gone back down to the level of, and that's normally where it sits when everything's healthy down here. So, that is how you clean out a grease trap. And had to do a little extra plumbing on top of that. So, I'm going to replace this J-pipe with my next vast fortune, read paycheck. Yes, I farted. Hey, I'm a guy. Anyway, that's what you have to do. Clean out a grease trap. Those of you who don't have one, who just have a garbage disposal under your kitchen sink, I envy you greatly. Okay, this is Artist Mac signing off. Houses. You gotta know how to do everything.